welcome to Glenelg for the SA Open, brought to you by the city of Holdfast Bay. I'm Dave Webb, joined by Max Gower, and we are underway for the men's Division 1 bronze medal match. Early start, and Ang Yang throwing, and we were just talking before we came on Earth, on Air Max, that's going to be one of the big issues today, is just trying to keep him in check today.
Yeah, Garang really showing there with its two ball that, you know, unless the Gregorys are putting Sam under pressure, Sam could just keep dishing up those passes all day for Garang to put away.
So the first match of the day, Sam Halley with Garang and Yang will be taking on Jack Gregory and Tim Gregory, brothers from Victoria. Touch on it. Second ball attack.
You will see Garang really going for that a lot, and Sam also will be putting the ball up every chance he can get. You know, Sam is a smaller player. You know, his big advantage is his pass, so he'll be wanting to use Garang's height and jump as much as possible.
So there's a lot of lot on the shoulders of Sam. Every first pass has to be perfect. Because you would imagine that the Gregorys will target.
Garang just getting the snicker on Tim Gregory on that serve. Not able to pull out quick enough. Oh, and that's beers though. You serve under the net in a game, that is beers for everyone on court. Unfortunate there for Garang. Could be an expensive round.
Well, we have spoken about that. Another sponsor of today is the Moseley Beach Club. Away to our right. Just couldn't find a way over, but again, that's something you were talking about before. Expect to see Tim and Jack, the Gregorys, they will show block and then pull back late.
Yeah, and you can see in that point, the wind is playing a bit with these sets, so unless the set is right on top of the net, you'll see the Gregorys pull because their strong suit is definitely in defense.
Just a little bit too much on that one.
On the first end, you've got Sam and Garang leading 4-3 at the switch with Jack Gregory back to serve. Funnily enough, both of these teams had identical scores in the semi-final, both losing 13-21 and 17-21 respectively.
Well, that's the first time we've seen him serve into the wind, and he certainly took all of that. Big bites out of that one. That's a massive block. And just that set, just a little bit low. Garang really needs to get over the top of that block, and if you don't get him high enough.
And Tim's blocking, you know, even though he's not up as high as some other blockers, he's got really good form, so you can't afford to just be hitting low into the net. But nice use there by Sam. Seeing the hands, tall and off the block outside.
So the wind is at the back of Garang at the moment. And that's going to be the issue as well, trying to get over the top of Garang. They're not the tallest two in the world, but they've seemed very, very smart. The Gregory brothers are very, very smart volleyballers.
All of these players on court right now will be pretty trained up in the wind, you know, coming from both Sydney and Victoria. And then Sam originally from WA, you know, we're playing on the beaches of Scarborough. You can have some of the windiest games ever, so bit uncharacteristic so far with a bit of these sets drifting off, but look to see these boys settle in and for a good game.
It'll just work out. The wind as they go. Excellent athleticism from Garang. A second go at the block as they try to tip over. Tried to go early, there was never enough height on that. to get any power on it.
Yeah, it was a good pass by Tim, but the two ball option was never there. Just trying to force things a bit too much on the Gregory side.
Excellent recovery. Drop back, almost a wonderful pickup, but they'll get the points. Another change of ends, 8-5.
8-6.
Yep. Sorry. We were ahead of the scorers then.
So 2-4-3 ends to start for Garang and Sam.
Just asked a little bit too much. The idea was there for Sam.
So you see Garang really trying to get those sets up tight for Sam so he can work off the block like he did on the other side in the last end. But one thing he really needs to make sure is once he's set, he's turning around and getting ready to cover.
So he's got a touch on the block. Going to be a free ball come back over for them. They made it work eventually.
Yeah, it looks like the Gregory's got caught in a bit of confusion there with Sam wanting that set to go a bit further behind than where Garang left it up. But Sam put it away, found the spot on the sand.
Good pick up again. Smart hitting from Sam. Saw the space down the line.
Yeah, nice little set play there by Garang and Sam. Garang jumping into the angle with Sam. Almost walking over to the line on that one and just, you know, knew that shot was coming. You've got Garang serving into the wind again.
It's really allowing him. It's a huge benefit. Again, we were talking about that. That wind that will be in Garang's face. He's just going to, if he gets the top spin right, he's just going to pull it down into court. And the Gregories are going to have to deal with it. Again, a great serve, and he's got a little bit of momentum now, Garang.
Yeah, following up after a serve that's going high over the shoulders of the Gregories and tagging the baseline. One that now drops a bit shorter on Jack, catching him off guard a bit. And the Gregories have swapped sides, so Tim is now in that deep corner with the wind coming off the water.
They've gone there again, and that's three in a row for Garang.
The switch was there, but it wasn't quite effective. Garang 1 point ahead of himself, almost walking off to the court, but no, you got one more time to serve another race if you want it.
He's got him again. It's a great pickup though, great first ball. And there they managed to bite back.
That's what the Gregories need to be doing. You can see Sam has been on the times where they've gone for the slower shots. Need to be going up, be aggressive, take on the defender, take on Garang. You'll have to wear a couple of blocks, but until he stops, until both of them start stopping the hard hits every time, you've got to keep going for it.
Very nearly the perfect end for Garang. He's just the one service short. Do you think that would have made up for going underneath the net, or is it still underneath the net? It just trumps everything.
Nah, still under the net trumps everything.
But he did his best to give himself a little bit of redemption, one service short. The Gregories find themselves 13 points to 8 down, but it's not the end of it. The rally point in beach volleyball is can turn around very, very quickly.
Yeah, I mean, you saw just then, you know, Garang with three aces in a row. You know, all we have to do is get a few serves, string them together into the wind, and anything can happen.
It is an absolutely wonderful day at the end of Jetty Road in Glenelg. You are wandering past, or
weather's really turned itself on,
hasn't it? Just got his measurements a little bit wrong. So yep. Sam Halley is going to have the chance to serve with the wind at his back.
There's been a few service errors from the Gregories now with the wind in their face serving into like the middle of the net. They really need to be going a lot higher and deep with those serves to put the pass under pressure.
Garang is an absolute wall at the net at the moment. And there'll just be questions coming into Gregory's mind. Like, you can't get over him. So attacking hard is going to be difficult for them. They have to start to be a little bit more cute around how they do it. Dig set spike is just not working for them at the moment.
I think they just need to start moving around their offense a bit. They're running quite straight forward. So Garang's pretty well set up. Takes a step there.
Yeah, and he's got him again.
Gets the block. You know, passing, you know, run a bit of a spread, you know, run the set out to the stick, just get Garang moving a bit more and, you know, get that quick arm going from the Gregorys, because they both have it. It's just at the moment they just seem to be waiting a bit, trying to shoot over him, where they've got to go back to just trying to get past him for speed.
So they're going to get a free shot this one. Comes over first time and good job it was the second ball, because I think that was all net. Garang now, cute over the top.
Great point there by Sam and Garang. Sam getting the dig on the no block in the first phase, and then Garang staying with it, getting that block touch. I think there was a little bit of a touch along with the net, and then putting the line shot perfectly away over the top of Jack.
Oh, a touch on the way through. They're always the ones you want back. You just wish you could pull them back on a string, couldn't you? And let it go.
That was a lot better by Tim there. You know, attacking a lot higher, but going, hitting into the wind, using the advantage that you have down this end of the beach.
Just seeing that Garang is able. He gets to set his feet so early, and they, like you said, they're not moving him laterally. Clips the net. That's a lovely weighted shot from Sam again.
Great first phase defense there by the Gregorys, getting the touch, having the opportunity to put it away, but Tim not being aggressive enough and just patting the ball down for Sam to, you know, have a second chance at it, go back on the line off the top of the block.
And again, Garang is there, but there you see the difference. The Gregorys are much more comfortable with Garang serving from that end. Certainly can't put as much venom on it.
Yeah, and you have a more consistent flight path of the ball. You know, when Garang's serving those jump serves into the wind, you know, sometimes he'll go deep, he'll, you know, take baseline. Other times, you know, bit of extra spin and it's going to drop right in front of you. Where with the wind at the back, you know, it's going to have a more consistent line.
Interesting moment there as well. Timeout was called. The Gregorys went and sat down. Sam and Garang just wanting to get back on with it. They certainly feel like they've got their foot on the loud pedal and they don't want to take it off right now.
I mean, they're 2 points away from finishing this set off and going on to the second, so they're not going to want to give the Gregorys any sniff of a chance.
See the sponsors on the right-hand side of the screen make all of this possible. Some really good South Australian names there. Nippies, orange juice. Well, it's just juice, isn't it? They do all sorts.
I mean, Nippies have ventured into the milks as well now, so...
No, they have as well, yeah. Haven't they? But certainly, I think I might be wandering over to the beach club, see whether we can get some takeaway. If I'm not drinking out of a pineapple by the end of the day, someone has let me down.
You can have a cocktail and a pineapple for you, and I'll grab the mocktail, just in case my coaches are listening. I'm being a good boy, I swear.
I promise it will be a mocktail. So Garang again into the wind. Can the Gregorys fare any better than last time? It doesn't start very well. And just body language, from a body language point of view, the Gregorys almost look defeated at the moment. It was that service end where Garang just went three on the bounce. They just seem to have lost a little bit of their mojo.
Three on the bounce and then coming down to, you know, the favoured end of the beach with the wind in your face and not being able to convert any break points for them either.
Much better first pass, and they've shown what they can do when they get it. Just want to see them pick themselves up.
Hopefully that point is the first of many to, you know, re-energise them, because we want this second set to come out and, you know, have a good fight.
Tim Gregory will float it. Again, smart and cute from Garang. Just a little angle one. And that, I think, is the end of the first one. None of the scorers are...
21-9.
21-9. And like I said, it was really close. The end that basically ended it, as it were, was that Garang service into the wind. And the Gregorys just didn't seem to be able to come back from that.
Yeah, going from 8-6, or 6-8 for the Gregorys, down after two ends to then 21-9. You know, they really got under pressure with Garang serve. And then you could just see, as you said, the body language and everything dropped a bit. You know, he's hoping that, you know, they've held on to a bit and they're going to come out here firing. You know, that's one thing that Sam and Garang will be talking about now. They'll be like, it's a new set. You know, take it as, like, you know, start of the game again. Don't expect the same thing from the Gregorys. You know, expect them to come out swinging.
There's quite a few family teams. I think we're going to see another one in the gold medal match, which is Justin Schumann and Damian Schumann. There's a lot of family there. I suppose that will have its negatives and its positives. Be a moment when that sibling rivalry might boil over during a timeout.
Yeah, I think, you know, one thing is, you've been playing with them, you're always around them, you know what each other are going to do, but yeah, I think it's rare to see those sibling teams really blow up. Especially like at a national tour, sometimes at world tour events it can go a bit pear-shaped.
Very well measured service, and again they do get over the block much better.
You can see there Garang just having to take at least just one lateral step and not being able to, like, load up for a long time. Jack a bit quicker with his shot, and he's getting it past the block, and that's what we're going to need from the Gregorys a lot more in this set.
That's a great service. Good first pass though. Over again to Sam, goes cross court, great pick up, second ball. Much, much better at hitting around Garang at the moment, and the block. And they have come out firing.
There you go, this is what we wanted from the boys. Jack has seemed to have found his serve now. A couple of really good serves deep on Sam. Sam just, you know, he's taking control of it though.
Just got them in there.
Too much time, it seems. He was expecting it to come a little bit quicker.
Yeah, I think that was it. I was just going to say, just caught in between two minds, and he couldn't really use his hands above his head or below his waist and got stuck between the two, really. But I think we're seeing the Gregorys vary the timing of their hits now, which, again, doesn't allow... Oh!
Garang's really racking up these aces in this game. Stuffing the stat sheet a bit.
Yeah, we're not keeping count, are we? It's a good job he's not doing a charity thing with aces. He'd be absolutely skimped by the end of the day.
Yeah, adding that along with his round of drinks, yeah.
Just got the aerial. Don't forget as well, ladies and gentlemen, this is the end of 2 days of volleyball. Just not quite enough. Saw Sam and Garang both back, just trying to drop it over the net. Just didn't get his calculations just right. Yeah, and they didn't move him at all. He set his feet on the first pass and didn't have to move at all.
Yep. Set his feet, jump in a little bit, take away that cross court, because that's one thing as a blocker, you know, if you're down at the end with the wind at your back, you know, those attackers are going to want to, you know, hit into that wind with the wind coming off on that bit of an angle corner to corner. Always knew that the attacker was going to favour that side.
Oh, that is smart. The disguise on that hit, everything about him when he went up suggested down the line. Everything.
Yeah, if it was planned, if it was just listening to his brother Jack, it was a great shot. You know, just out of the reach of Garang with Sam running to the line, they had no chance.
Second ball attack, and
just a little bit too quick of the pass from Sam, only, you know, giving Garang one option if he's going up to hit it. Has to go cross, and Tim jumping up and taking that away nicely.
Sam now will look, and he just wipes it off the block, and the touch was enough to take it away from Jack Gregory. Couldn't get enough purchase on it to bring it back in.
Yeah, I reckon if that just missed him, then Jack would have had that dig, but you know, it's one thing Sam's really good at, just collecting just that small amount of the block.
Oh, and he's back. Oh, out. He's back to his end, and we can't quite see the baseline from where we are. We'll see whether we can get a replay of how close it was.
Either way, though, it's a gutsy leave with how Garang's been serving from that end. That one a bit of an easier leave.
Yeah, that was a more simple leave when it's passing you at head height with the wind coming into you. I know it was actually, there was a fair bit in there. There was no need to go to Hawkeye for that one. Better cross court hit. And I tell you, that was a brave leave as well.
Yeah, brave leave slash maybe just outside of his reach anyway. So it's the, you know, almost pleading just out. But a good hit from there from Tim, getting Sam up in his chest, you know, where he can't control that dig enough.
Again, smart hitting from Sam. Another change of end.
Gregory's lining up with a double defense down there on the line. You know, both taking that line away, but you know, Sam nice and controlled, just cutting that ball over into the cross court. A better start here for the second set from the Gregories. 7-7.
There was a touch there as well, and again, finally they get around the block.
Better aggression there as well, you know, sets further off, you know, but rather than trying to slow down, not going to back myself in, hit hard, hit cross.
Into the wind yet. Just want to see them take the dogs off the leash a little bit more when they're hitting. It does. I mean, it must be hard when you're looking at the immense wingspan of Garang. Again, just that height where they can't quite get the dig and they can't volley it. It's just really smart hitting from Sam.
Those boys, though, they'll see that as a missed opportunity. They could have had that dig. And really, they need to be converting those.
Big shout of cut, cut, cut. He's seen. Again, they've gone double line again.
Much faster hit, like, again. Yeah, I think the boys might have been tuning into our live stream, talking about how they need to speed up their attack a bit, because so far they're doing just that and they're leading 9-8.
Maybe they can lip read us. Oh, there's no argument about that one, and there was no way that was coming back.
Yeah, they really needed to get a blocker up at the net for that one. You don't want to just you know, leave it open for Garang to set the ball on top of the net for Sam to put away.
That one's long, you could see that early. But just pulled up a little bit properly as well, Garang, after that. Where they landed awkwardly. Or it's just a blame. Serve one out because of happening.
Yeah.
Good pick up again. Free ball will come over. What can the Gregories do with it? And smart and accurate hitting from Sam. He's shown as well, there's a repertoire there for young Sam, isn't there?
Yeah, Gregory's calling there, trying to get the carry call on that dig from Sam, unsuccessfully. Umpire having none of it.
That one will find its way out, and certainly a much closer second set. There's a timeout called, 11 points to 10. The Gregories can sit down in front. Is that the first time that they've sat down in front today?
Yep, much better, start to this set, leading at the tech. Now we've got to see them hold on to it, though. Grang and Sam know that they can get on a roll here. They're going down to the wind in their face end. So, all it can take, like the first set, is, one of the servers, Grang or Sam, to get on a bit of roll, stick a couple of aces in there, and all of a sudden, they'll be back up.
Just trying to, I haven't seen much volleyball this year, especially not the beach volleyball, and so I'm coming into it cold and blind. And to be honest, if you looked at the first set, I would have expected this to go straight sets. Now I'm not so sure. The Gregories really have come out in this second set and marked down their intent. A lot more cerebral with their hitting and moving Garang around when he's at the net.
I think what we saw with the Gregories at the start, though, was just a lot of errors creeping into their game and just bad options. So as soon as they cleaned that up, it was going to be a lot closer.
Oh, that caught the tape. We saw the tape move from here, and that was scrambling work, but they got there. They make it a little bit harder for themselves, don't they?
Yeah, but that point there is golden. Getting a break point with, down at what a lot of players would call the bad end. It's a great way to start out of the tech and getting a second.
Yeah, I am a big student of body language, and it seems strange to me that you just saw Garang there to sort of look at the sky as if to say things are falling apart. They're not.
Not at all. You're just a couple of serves away from a massive swing in points.
Well, and that was always going to be a problem. There you see the wind. Just made it more and more inviting for Garang as the set went up.
Yeah, the set just drifting onto that and bringing Garang into play. Getting the block, that was steady him a bit. He's gone, he's gotten that block, gotten them back within two, back to serve.
Yeah, Gregory's then have to deal with this serve again. A much better first pass and a great hit, great pickup. Oh, wonderful rally from the two, from both these sides. And then you do feel like, you yourself are a tall player. I think if you're having to play the ball as it's coming straight at your head, it's very, very difficult to deal with.
Yeah, especially when you're dropping off the net like Garang was just then. He hadn't stopped. His feet weren't steady. So you're moving back. Your eye level's changing. To then try and dig that ball was very difficult. But credit to the Gregories. They're making Garang move a bit more now.
Yeah, which it feels like you have to do with the big fellas, the tall timber. And they will change ends. And they've certainly stamped their authority on this one.
Just taking a timeout, Sam and Garang there, after another error from Sam. Sam's really trying to work that line, hitting into the wind, but off the side of the hand, just going out wide.
Just trying to work out whether that wind is getting stronger as we go. You would expect it to on a warm day today. We know it changes around and will go offshore at some point, but it hasn't over the last couple of years.
Yeah, throughout the game, you just have, stronger gusts of wind. You might shift around, might turn around a bit. But that's one thing as a, players out here, you're always ready for that. You've got to adapt quick. And, so far, the Gregory is actually serving great from the, in this end, from the bad end, putting Sam under a bit of passing pressure. He's not able to get a good pass up there, up in the net for Garang to hit on two. They're making Sam play the ball.
Yeah, and you can see the disappointment from Sam as well as he comes out from his timeout. Just the 4 points behind. The serve will be with the Gregorys. You know that the first ball is, they're going to aim to get it on the top of Sam's head. See whether he can get the second ball attack this time. Good leave from Sam.
That's a good timeout. Always say that after you call a timeout and they serve an error. That's a good timeout.
Great timeout. Just put the kicker on ice, as it were. He's not made friends with that line, has he? He's fallen out with it in the last couple of minutes.
Yeah, it looked like he was really thinking that the wind was going to pull that ball in a lot more than it did. Maybe just a bit like, putting on the green, just hit it with a bit too much pace, hit through the break.
Float will just drop. Sam will have the hit again. Manages to get off the block. Second ball attack in the wind. And that's what we were talking about with Gustav. I feel like they've got away with one then because he was not set for that hit. The wind is gusting and everything looked perfect for him. And then just at the last minute, it ended up behind him.
Great little touch off the head of the blocker there. And then one thing you're always told, if you're off on the net, you got to put that ball deep. Make the other team turn around to play that ball.
Saw it drift again, a lot better. And now, said to let the dogs off the leash. Not all of them at once, Gurang. Nothing worse than seeing it sail over the baseline.
Yeah, he saw an open net. The blocker coming up late, went to hit it hard and just missing the proper hand contact, looking like it's coming off a bit more fingers than a bit of the palm.
Now the Gregorys now certainly starting to ease through the gears.
Yeah, stringing points together now. Switch up there on that point, serving Garang. They haven't really done that all game, but working out. He's, after hitting out by a couple of metres, he goes back to a shot where the Gregorys is sitting on it waiting for that shot and converting their chance.
Quite smart as well from Garang, taking his time, cleaning up his equipment. He's had a couple of points where he won't be happy with himself. Oh, sneaky, like an assassin in the night. Never expect that from the big fella, would you?
Almost a bit of the egg on the face moment.
Very, very close.
A lot of the net. It's one thing that, couldn't annoy a passer more if you had a standing two ball into the net. But came off, worked out for him.
Scott hands on again. Could go second. Sam not happy that was going out, so will hit. No touch, out. So they are 1 point away from evening this matchup. One set apiece.
The spread block working for the
Gregorys
there,
getting
their hands out of the way.
Set point into the wind, you couldn't ask for any better. Garang rises high, that's better from the big fella.
Jack annoyed with himself there, but he made a good move, got his hand in the way, but really just kind of got to give that one to Garang.
That's just
you hit
power.
High, got the outside of your hands. Just come back side out this point here.
Still have a really, really big cushion. Oh, just a little bit too far. I think they've still got the 6 point cushion, I think, or if they...
Well, they're up, should be 20 to 15 at that switch. Still with the side out. Still plenty of time to get this set off, but I don't want to be giving Sam and Garang too much momentum.
I mean, the good news is they will avoid Garang's serve. Big wingspan from the big fella, and that's a nice touch, and that will even the sets up. The Gregorys will even it up one set apiece.
much better from the Gregories there, coming out from the start, you know, hanging with Sam and Garang, you know, tight first couple of events, and then just as Garang and Sam did the first set, string a few defensive points in a row, get that score line to spread out a bit, and then they really took their opportunities when, you know, Sam was giving them some errors, and then they went back and were siding out straight away. So captains both up in the net, choosing where they want to start the set, if they want to serve, if they want to side out.
So, okay, you've won the rock, paper, scissors. Which way are you going?
A lot of teams, are, you know, they'll with this win now, they'll take the end. They'll want to serve into the win because general rule of thumb is and the other team will take the side out. When there's less wind around, you know, you'd take the side out. You want to have that first opportunity to attack.
We've seen in this game that if either team can get a 4 or 5 point run, again, it's reaching the end of a very long weekend for these blokes. So they, you know, 4 or 5 point run possibly can just demoralise you a little bit more than it would have done first thing yesterday morning.
Oh, and even more so now that it's in a third set, only going to 15 points. If the other team has a 5 point run against you, that's making your life extremely difficult. Even a 2-3 point run, you don't want to be giving those up in the third set because things just happen so quickly.
So third place will take home $375. Fourth place will take $225. So they're playing for about $150, and I think Garang needs that based on
especially
the service under the net.
If some of the guys, you know, also look for those cocktails in a... Ooh,
caught
I don't
it.
Know about I that. I
mean, yeah, he was very definite about it, though. It looked like it caught the tape to me.
I reckon he got a bit lucky there. Yep, Sam even then was like saying, nah, that ball was in. But the linesman, the ref, have called it out. You know, bit of luck for them at the start, and they're going to take it.
Nice, smart hit from the Gregories. There's a lot of court to cover, and especially if you've tried to run around on soft sand, if you're not a volleyballer, even just walking around on soft sand is difficult, so it's a lot of court to cover.
Yeah, your calves start burning, you know, your feet are just sinking that little bit more in. And especially then, Sam, you know, made that step to try and go to the cross court, so anything that goes back the other way is always hard to, you know, readjust.
He's gone for the second hit, and he'll want that one back. Just didn't quite get enough on it.
All right, danger man back to serve now with Garang.
Yeah, this is what they wanted, wasn't it? They've got him serving at this end. Might give them that 3 or 4 point cushion if he can serve as well as he has been doing, and they're going to get it straight back away. Lovely touch from the big fella.
Calmly puts that ball down the line. That's what they missed in that second set, which is creating a few more points from this end with the wind in their face.
Gregory certainly have sorted themselves out with the Garang serve, but just one too many weak bicks this morning, and that one's gone long. And they are starting to get that roll.
Big end for Garang and Sam coming out with the 4-1 lead, especially after I think the Gregory's, you know, got chipped a bit. I'm pretty sure that was an ace on that very first point.
Yeah.
Sam reckons it was in as well.
It's nice to have a little bit of controversy for the viewers at home, isn't it?
Yeah, one thing, you know, Sam will take that. You know, he did his best. He was like, oh, I thought that was in, but, you know, the ref didn't want to listen, so.
Oh, almost a great pickup.
Tim back to serve. He was quite effective in that last set, you know, creating a bit of havoc on the other side.
He just started to find his rhythm, didn't he?
Good pass by Halley. Yeah,
wonderful first pass. Oh, it's unlucky.
Jack just turning off the block and taking those first two steps straight at his brother there, which is not what you want to be doing as a blocker when you're turning. You want to keep yourself open, and be able to move for that ball, because you could see there he was having to turn back around with his back to where the ball was coming from, trying to get it out of the net.
In, no touch. Less decisive, the young man tore away to our right, but still gave it in.
Yeah, it's a big job that these, I've done these guys have.
I've done it. Tell you what, some of the looks you get at times. Again, that's close to the net.
Unlucky. Getting the net touch. Oh. He was on the block. Great spot, but you know, maybe it was just his shirt flicking the net a bit, and unfortunately, you know, that's a fault.
Yeah, again, if you're new to volleyball, if you're just watching this, you've just found this as you're YouTube surfing, you cannot touch the net.
Oh, it looks like his arm there. Yeah. Arm catching the top of the net. Either way, point the other way, and then the serve going out long.
So another change of ends. 6 points to three. Sam and Garang. And they're at the dangerous service end. They are receiving, though, to begin.
Now this is actually where the Gregorys got most of their points on Sam, was serving from the wind of their back, creating, you know, that chance where Sam had to put that ball long.
Oh, that one was out. We're happy with that one.
Sam with a little fist pump there.
Well, that's a big call. Oh, that's close, and well, the last touch came off Garang's and it's gone out.
Well played there. So that was a joust, something there where both players are actually touching the ball simultaneously. So then in this instance, where the ball comes off Garang, out of the court.
Looked like a last touch anyway. Cross court hit, it allows the Gregorys to come and set. Second ball attack. Cute again, great rally from the two teams. It's going to continue. That's the pass
huge
from
rally here.
Garang. Oh, and just to that line again.
Gregory's just sticking with that rally a little bit longer. The set not quite where Sam was expecting it to be. Didn't quite get his feet there. Looking quite off balance as he hit it. And just putting the ball out on the side.
And again, if you watch that, they showed block. And then moving away, just changed his mind. I think he was looking to try and go over the top of the block to loop it over, and then all of a sudden he knew he was going to have to hit. He had two deep defenders.
Okay, another error now here from Sam. Garang and Sam need to change something up here. If Sam can get that ball up for Garang to hit on two, Garang needs to back himself in for it. Not like a couple points ago where he tried to do a cheeky little knuckle down the line. Or Garang needs to get that set up a lot tighter. Just like that.
A much better, and this time he does make friends with that line and finally gets a little bit of it. They're going to have the serve with the wind at the back. Can't quite see whether it's Sam or Garang. I think it's Sam, and Sam's been very effective with the wind at his back. His service style is it's interesting to watch. He starts very, very low. Close again.
Good self-cover there by Jack after. And Garang, nice high swing off the top of the block.
Good volleyball all round.
Garang back to serve, up 9-7. Looking to solidify their lead here.
Well, that's a great serve. He's happy with that one.
It's a very tough serve to go line to line. Yeah,
in this
with
wind.
All the wind is doing in that one is pushing the ball out to the right, and he's just collected the line. You can understand why, you know, Tim has left that ball, because you're not expecting that to tag the line.
That had absolutely no right to land on the line. There's the beautiful Jetty Road foreshore. Not been on the big wheel. Have you been on the big wheel yet?
No. I haven't. All the years it's been here, I haven't actually gotten on it.
The wonderful part of the world.
If you had to choose one, though, would you get on the giant wheel or would you go into the Moseley Beach Club?
Moseley Beach Club, probably. Yeah. Well, the Big Wheel hasn't sponsored us, so the Big Wheel sponsors us next year, then I'll be all over the Big Wheel. But this year, it's definitely the Beach Club.
Right, coming out of the timeout here, Gregory's need to side out. Need to get this point back, go back to serve and create something.
He's found his rhythm from the other side as well as Garang. They'll back off and they get the touch and they do get the side out. Because if you're honest, if you give yourself a four, if you're giving yourself a 4 point, 5 point deficit, oh, a little bit of controversy from somewhere, no?
Just trying to figure out who's going back to serve.
Right. You have to then be absolutely faultless.
Yeah.
Playing faultless volleyball is not easy.
No, you need to be able to create a lot of points in the, and with these boys, you know, the way it's showing up, they're going to have to go down to the bad end to finish off this set, and that's even harder.
And there is a problem. If you imagine as a blocker, and Garang has got the ability to go up, and if you knew he was just going to try and hit the bladder out of it,
just
that
out
one
long.
Was out, it was just long. If you knew that all he was going to do was try and hit the bladder out of it, you could go up with confidence as a blocker, but he's got such a range of shots.
Yeah, and that's where you've seen the, you know, that's where the Gregory's change up their different defensive tactics, where, you know, they're jumping cross, jumping line, double up on the line, or, as has proved quite effective on Sam from this end, pulling.
Well, that's a good pickup. Just the gust of wind is taking him way away from the net, but kind of feel like he's a lot more comfortable further away from the net, Garang.
And it's also like, you know, the blocker's then pulling, and so you have a little bit more of that freedom to go for that hit and hit hard, not, you know, knowing that, you know, the blocker's not right there.
I tell you what, the wind has just picked up, and it's picked up at exactly the wrong time for the Gregory's.
Big serve off the chest there.
Oh, and tell you what, the first pass under the circumstances was really, really good. And now they have found themselves in a little bit of a hole.
Yeah, just a bit of a mistouch there from Jack, or potentially thinking he's a little bit closer to the net. You know, shooting that into the bottom of it.
That's a great first ball. Dropped off. It's going to come eventually, but you think it's going to be an easy one for the Gregor. Oh, my word. That wind is not going to... Oh, that's unbelievable work from Sam.
Oh, pretty easy.
Yeah. Oh, the second hit comes. Now, they've got match point, and it's on Garang's serve. What a great rally again. I thought he'd absolutely sold him down the river. That's an incredible...
Yeah, nice little get out of the net there. You know, Gregory's, though, they really needed that point. They had their chances.
And there you go, end on an ace. That's the way to do it. Garang and Young and Sam Halley will pick up the bronze medal. Good game of volleyball. And just, there was no real difference between the two sides, was there?
No, it really was just, you know, whichever team just got a couple of point run. You know, for Garang and Sam, it was... You know, usually caused by Garang serving with the wind in the face. You know, for the second set, the Gregory's were creating a little bit of an issue for Sam when they were serving from the wind at the back end. It was really just whoever could string those points together, you know, and then just hold strong in their side out and keep that lead.
And that was the story of the game. In the first set, we saw Garang and Sam, certainly they managed to push it out. A lot closer in the third and final set, you would have to say. But, ladies and gentlemen, we will take a break as we get ready for the women's bronze medal match, which will be coming up at, what's the time? That will be at 12, nope, not 12:30. That's the one we've just done. It will be coming up at 1:30. Lucy Ambagshir. I'll make sure we're right before
Ambagshir,
we get to it.
Yep.
And then Gudrun Schobert, the South Australian pairing, taking on Lucy Knight and Kendall Hazlett. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll see you back at around half one, which is around in 10 minutes' time. Ladies and gentlemen, we hope to see you then. Goodbye.